Hi all, in this video we are going to discuss about vernier scale. There are two types of vernier scale, bicuspid vernier and forward vernier. In the bicuspid vernier, the vernier divisions are marked in the opposite direction as that of the main scale. In the forward vernier, the vernier divisions are marked in the same direction as that of the main scale. I will discuss one question, and we can solve the question using both forward and bicuspid vernier scales. The question is, construct a scale of RF equals 1 by 2.5 to show decimeters and centimeters, and by a vernier to read millimeters, to measure up to 4 decimeters. Mark on the scale lengths of 2.26 decimeter and 0.57 decimeter. First, I will solve the question by drawing a bicuspid vernier scale. Okay, the RF is given in the question. It is equal to 1 by 2.5. Now, we have to find out the length of scale, which is equal to RF into length to be measured. In the question, it is given that we have to measure up to 4 decimeter. Therefore, length to be measured equals 4 decimeter. Therefore, length of scale equals 1 by 2.5 into 4 decimeter. That is 1 by 2.5 into 4 into 100 millimeters, which is 160 mm. Therefore, 4 decimeter is represented as 160 mm. Okay, now I am drawing a line of length 160 mm. Now I am going to draw a box of height 1.5 cm. You can take 2 cm or 1.5 cm. I am naming the box as A, B, C and D. The length of AB is 160 mm. Now I am going to divide that 160 mm into 4 equal parts. That is, I am dividing 4 decimeter into 4 equal parts. Each part is of length 1 decimeter. Okay, now I am drawing vertical lines from all the points. Now I divided 4 decimeter into 4 equal parts. That is 0, 1 decimeter, 2 decimeter, 3 decimeter. Okay, that length is 1 decimeter and that length is 2 decimeter, 3 decimeter and 4 decimeter. Now I am going to divide the first division, that is 1 decimeter, into 10 equal parts. Therefore, each part is having a length of 0.1 decimeter or 1 centimeter. Okay, now we divided 1 decimeter into 10 equal parts. Therefore, each part is of length 0.1 decimeter or 1 centimeter. Okay, that is 0.1 decimeter, 0.2, 0.3, 0.4, 0.5, 0.6, 0.7, 0.8, 0.9 and 1 decimeter. Now we have to mark the vernier divisions. So I am extending a line from D and I am measuring the length of 0.1 decimeter and I am cutting an arc. Okay, therefore now we have 1.1 decimeter, that is 11 centimeter, and I am going to construct a box by considering that 11 centimeter or 1.1 decimeter. This is the method of marking vernier divisions in backward vernier scale. Now we have 11 divisions, that is 11 centimeter or 1.1 decimeter. Now I am going to divide that 11 centimeter or 1.1 decimeter into 10 equal parts. Therefore, each part is having a length of 0.11 decimeter. Each division in the vernier scale is having a length of 0.11 decimeter. Okay, that is 0 decimeter. Next point is 0.11 decimeter, 0.22 decimeter. I am not marking all the points, therefore that is 0.44 decimeter, 0.66 decimeter, 0.88 decimeter.
How can we mark 2.26 decimeter on this scale? There is a method I will show you, therefore look at here.
Our vernier scale divisions are 0.11 decimeter, 0.22 decimeter and like that. Therefore, we can write 2.26 decimeter minus 0.11 decimeter equals 2.15 decimeter. Similarly, 2.26 minus 0.22 equals 2.04 decimeter. 2.26 minus 0.33 equals 1.93 decimeter. 2.26 minus 0.44 equals 1.82 decimeter. 2.26 minus 0.55 equals 1.71 decimeter. 2.26 minus 0.66 equals 1.6 decimeter. This 1.6 decimeter we can easily show on the scale. Therefore, we can write 1.6 decimeter plus 0.66 decimeter equals 2.26 decimeter. First, we have to show 1.6 decimeter. Therefore, we have to divide that third division into 10 equal parts. Each division is 0.1 decimeter. Okay, that is 0.1 decimeter, 0.2 decimeter, 0.3, 0.4, 0.5, 0.6, 0.7, 0.8, 0.9, and 1 decimeter, that is 2 decimeter actually. Now we have to find 1.6 decimeter. Okay, that is 0.6. Okay, that is 1.6 decimeter. Therefore, I am drawing a projection line from 1.6 decimeter. Okay, that length is 1.6 decimeter. Now we have to find 0.66 decimeter. Okay, that is 0.44 decimeter and that is 0.66 decimeter. Okay, I am drawing a projection line from 0.66 decimeter. The distance between these two projection lines gives the length 2.26 decimeter. That is 1.6 decimeter plus 0.66 decimeter. Okay, I am dimensioning the value. Okay, this is 2.26 decimeter. Now we have to mark 0.57 decimeter. We can write 0.57 decimeter as follows. 0.77 decimeter minus 0.2 decimeter gives 0.57 decimeter. First, we have to find 0.77 decimeter. Okay, that point is 0.77 decimeter. I am drawing a projection line from 0.77 decimeter. Now, we have to find 0.2 decimeter. Okay, that point is 0.2 decimeter. I am marking the points clearly. Okay, that is 0.2 decimeter. I am drawing a projection line from 0.2 decimeter. The distance between these two projection lines gives the length 0.57 decimeter. I am dimensioning the value. Okay, that length is 0.57 decimeter. Okay, on the right side we can write decimeter, and on the left side we can write centimeter, because it is of the order of centimeter, that is 1 centimeter, 2 centimeter, up to etc. up to 1 decimeter. RF is 1 by 2.5. Okay, I hope you understood the bicuspid vernier scale. Now we can solve the same question using forward vernier scale. Okay, we know the value of RF and we already calculated the length of scale. It is 160 mm. Therefore, 4 decimeter is represented as 160 mm. The initial procedure is same as bicuspid vernier scale. I drew a box of length 160 mm which represents 4 decimeter, and then I divided 4 decimeter into 4 equal parts. Each part is of length 1 decimeter. Then I divided 1 decimeter into 10 equal parts, where each part is 0.1 decimeter or 1 centimeter. Now look at here, we have to mark vernier scale divisions. In forward vernier scale, we are taking only 9 main scale divisions. That is, here I am taking only 0.9 decimeters or 9 centimeter. And I am drawing a box of length 0.9 decimeter. Now I am dividing this 9 decimeter into 10 equal parts. Therefore, each part is 0.09 decimeter or 0.9 centimeter. Okay, we can mark points. Okay, first point is 0, then 0.09. I am not marking all the points, therefore next I am marking 0.27, then 0.45, 0.63, 0.81, and finally 0.9. Okay, the unit is decimeter. We have to mark 2.26 decimeter. There is a method, therefore look at here. We can write 2.26 decimeter minus 0.09 decimeter equals 2.17 decimeter. Similarly, we can write 2.26 minus 0.18 equals 2.18 decimeter. 2.26 minus 0.27 equals 1.99 decimeter. 2.26 minus 0.36 equals 1.9 decimeter. This 1.9 we can easily mark, therefore we can write 1.9 decimeter plus 0.36 decimeter gives 2.26 decimeter. for marking 1.9 decimeter, I am dividing the third division into 10 equal parts. That is, I am dividing 1 decimeter into 10 equal parts. Each part is having length of 0.1 decimeter or 1 centimeter. Okay, I am marking points as 1.1 decimeter, 1.2 decimeter, 1.3 decimeter, 1.4 decimeter, 1.5 decimeter, 1.6 decimeter, 1.7 decimeter, 1.8 decimeter, 1.9 decimeter, and finally 2 decimeter. Now we have to mark points, therefore look carefully. First, we have to mark 1.9 decimeter. From 0 to 1.8, it is 1.8 decimeter, but there is an extra 0.1 decimeter. Therefore, total, when we draw a projection line from 1.8, it is 1.9 decimeter actually. Therefore, I am drawing a projection line from 1.8 decimeter. Now, we have to find 0.36 decimeter. We are taking 4 vernier scale divisions. Each division is 0.09 decimeter. Therefore, when we take 4 divisions, it is 0.36 decimeter. Therefore, I am drawing a projection line from 0.36 decimeter, and the distance between the projection line is 2.26 decimeter. I am dimensioning the value. 2.26 decimeter is represented as 1.9 decimeter plus 0.36 decimeter. Now we have to mark 0.57 decimeter. We can write as follows. 0.3 decimeter plus 0.27 decimeter equals 0.57 decimeter. We can easily mark 0.3 decimeter on main scale. For marking 0.3 decimeter, I am dividing second division into 10 equal parts. That is, I am dividing 1 decimeter into 10 equal parts. Each part is having length of 0.1 decimeter or 1 centimeter. Okay, I am marking points as 0.1 decimeter, 0.2 decimeter, 0.3, 0.4, 0.5, 0.6, 0.7, 0.8, 0.9, and finally 1 decimeter. Now we have to mark 0.3 decimeter. From 0 to 0.2, it is 0.2 decimeter. But there is an extra 0.1 decimeter. Therefore, 0.1 plus 0.2 gives 0.3 decimeter. Therefore, I am drawing a projection line from 0.2 decimeter. Now I have to mark 0.27 decimeter. For that I am taking 3 vernier scale divisions. Each division is 0.09 decimeter, therefore 3 divisions gives 0.27 decimeter. Therefore I am drawing a projection line from 0.27 decimeter, and therefore 0.3 plus 0.27 gives 0.57 decimeter. Therefore the distance between the projection lines gives 0.57 decimeter and I am dimensioning it. We can write decimeter on the right side and centimeter on the left side. RF of the scale is 1 by 2.5. Therefore, forward vernier scale is completed. I hope you understood both forward and backward vernier scale. If you like the video, subscribe my channel and click the bell icon also. Thank you.